Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to another summer week of The Kingdom for Kids. My name is Miss Lauren, and I'm so excited to be back again for our lesson this morning. Today, we're going to be talking about the narrow gate. This is a very important lesson from the Sermon on the Mount that teaches us how Jesus is the only way to heaven. So let's learn some more about what this means. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 13 to 14, Jesus tells the people about a narrow and wide gate. So let's read those verses together. It says, "Enter through the narrow gate, for the wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only a few find it." Jesus says to enter through the narrow gate, not the wide one. But hold on, I don't know about you guys, but I don't see a physical narrow gate anywhere around me right now. I don't have two gates like that at home, and I don't see any around me right here.
Wait, Mr. Alfred. I don't have gates like that either. I mean, Jerry has a gate for his pen where he sleeps, but there's only one gate. And I can't remember if it's narrow or wide. Mr. Alfred, do you have gates we could go in?
Oh, Jimmy, let's keep watching. I have a feeling Miss Lauren will explain what Jesus meant very soon.
Well, good news, boys and girls. We don't have to worry. It isn't a physical gate that Jesus is referring to. So, if Jesus wasn't talking about a physical gate, then what kind of gate did he mean? The gates Jesus is referring to really means the way that we choose to live our lives, what we choose to act like, and most importantly, who we follow. We have two options when it comes to deciding how we are going to live.
Phew! Do you hear that, Mr. Alfred? No real gates.
Yep, I heard. Let's keep listening. I want to hear about those two options.
I want you to close your eyes and try to imagine these two gates with me. One option is to walk through this really wide gate. This gate has tons of people going through it. We can imagine the gate to be really shiny and pretty. You couldn't miss it if you had to walk by. Here, people choose to follow the ways of the world. People may choose to do basically whatever they really want, which sounds really good to our human ears.
Wait, whatever I want? So I could eat all the cookies I want? Whoa, that sounds awesome. What would you do if you could do whatever you want, Mr. Alfred?
Take a vacation, a nice long vacation.
Our second option is to walk through this really narrow gate. The gate is more hidden and isn't as appealing to our human eyes, and there aren't as many people that find and choose to enter this one. This gate is where people choose to follow Jesus. Through this gate, people obey God and do what he says, not what we say. Down this road, there are rules and guidelines as to how to live, things we should and shouldn't do, given to us by God himself that are written in the Bible. Though the wide gate sounds more fun to us, and sometimes there are more people who go through it, Jesus calls us to not follow that big crowd, no matter how much fun it looks. Sometimes we think that doing what we want is best, but it really isn't. What if you ate all the cookies you wanted? What would happen? You'd make yourself sick.
I never thought of that. How'd you know I was going to eat the cookies?
Miss Lauren is right, Jimmy. Sometimes when we do what we want, we end up with the consequences we may have not thought about.
You see, when we go down this road and do what we want, we may choose to laugh at mean jokes with our friends, make fun of others who are different from us. We might not even want to listen to our parents because we want to do what we want to do. And by doing what we want, we could actually really hurt ourselves and other people. Jesus tells us that we should not go down this road for our own safety, not because he doesn't want us to have fun. Jesus knows that sometimes our fun can end up hurting people.
Just like last week when Pastor Andrew was having fun, but he made Pastor Joel upset.
Yeah, Pastor Andrew forgot to use the golden ruler. So wait, if doing what we want isn't a good idea, then what should we do?
Let's keep watching to find out.
That's why God gives us commandments in the Bible, to guide us and to help us have a good life. The biggest reason Jesus tells us to stay away from this wide gate is because those who walk through the wide gate and follow their own hearts don't get to go to heaven one day. They will instead have to go to hell and suffer forever because they didn't choose the right gate. Instead of the wide gate, Jesus tells us to take the narrow gate. It might not look as pretty on the outside as the wide one, and there might not be as many people going through it, but it is the gate that leads to Jesus and to heaven. And by walking through this gate, we choose to follow him, and we can go to heaven one day.
Wait! What? The people who go through the wide gate don't go to heaven? That's so sad. I want to go through the narrow gate. How do I get there, Mr. Alfred? How do I walk through the narrow gate so I get to go to heaven?
Well, let's wait and see if Miss Lauren will explain it further.
We walk through it by saying that we believe in God and truly believing it in our hearts. And we want to do what he says. We want to obey all the things that Jesus tells us to do. And by obeying these things, we are becoming more like Jesus every single day. And we know that when our time is done on earth, we will go to heaven to be with Jesus.
I don't get it yet, Mr. Alfred. In order to go to heaven to be with Jesus, I have to believe in God and do what he says?
That's right, Jimmy. That is the definition of faith in Jesus, and that is how we walk through the narrow gate.
Matthew 7, verse 13 to 14, told us that the narrow gate is the way to life, eternal life. There is only one way to reach this eternal life, and we hear about it in the book of John, chapter 14, verse 6. It says, Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Did you guys hear that? Jesus says, I am the way. Do you know what that means? Jesus is the narrow gate.
Talk about a plot twist. Jesus is the narrow gate. Whoa.
He sure is. We're almost done. Let's hear what else Miss Lauren has to say.
Jesus is the truth and the way we have eternal life. Because he suffered and died on the cross to wash away all of our sin and then rose again, we can now go to heaven to be with Jesus. But it is really important to know that the only way we can do that is through Jesus. That means believing in Jesus with all your heart and choosing to do what he says, not what we want or think is best. What we want leads to destruction and a big mess. What Jesus wants leads to life with God in heaven forever. I don't know about you, but I believe in Jesus and I want to do what he says so I can go to heaven to be with him one day. And I pray with all my heart that you do too. Have a great week, everyone. Bye.
Well, Jimmy, what did you think? Do you want to do what Miss Lauren said at the end? I know I do.
Yeah, I really do. I want to believe in God and do what he says.
That's wonderful, Jimmy. And by choosing to do that, you are entering the narrow gate. That is, Jesus.
Yay! Can I have a cookie now, Mr. Alfred? I promise I'll only eat one.
Okay, Jimmy. Just one.
Yes! Cookies! Cookies! Cookies!